Hello and welcome to the editorial analysis of the Hindu. Today we shall be discussing the editorial of the 23rd of September. So coming to the first article, the nationalist hindrance to climate actions. This is an important article because the debate about climate action vis-a-vis the entire scenario where globalization is being replaced by nationalist interest is what is very much in news. And this article is precisely that, and that is why this article becomes important for us. The context is that recently the United Nations Climate Action Summit is what is going on. So in that particular context, climate change and actions that are being taken is what becomes important. So that is what is the entire context of this particular article. Now coming to the analysis. Basically, the first issue that is important is a keyword also, that a scientific alarm on climate change is what has been raised, what has been time and again mooted by the scientific eclipse of the world. It has been accepted internationally. This refers to some visible science as well as the science behind climate change. Now, basically, what is important here is that the 5 years since 2015 is said to be the warmest of any equivalent recorded period. The sea level rise is accelerating. The oceans have become 26% more acidic since the dawn of the Industrial Revolution. Also, the recent weather events bring into focus the likely implications of a warming world, is what has been talked about in the editorial. This summer saw Delhi-like temperatures across to Europe. The Hurricane Dorian is what is important, rendered large parts of the Bahamas unlivable. And this is what also resulted in the rise of fires in the Amazon forest, which recently was seen by a major forest in Amazon. Now, all of these events are what are very, very important. We will have to talk about climate change. And in that context, what becomes important is that you give current examples, current events which have taken place, and this is a summary of all of those, so you will have to make a note of these. Also, several heat waves of what was seen in France as well as Germany. So globally, the phenomenon of climate change is what is a reality, and scientific alarms is what have been raised in this context. So that is what the editorial is highlighting in its first analysis. The second issue that has been discussed here is with regards to the social action that has been taken place. Now, basically, social action refers to the action that is taken by the people as such, by the society. Now, there is an upwelling in this particular direction. People are taking more and more action. It is the people who are coming into the limelight now. This is in the backdrop of the growing evidence of climate change, both scientifically. First and foremost, we are getting these scientific reports. Also, very, very important, experientially. Climate change a few years back, approximately 10 years back, was something that was only spoken about. But now climate change is something that people are experiencing in their day-to-day lives, and this is prompting people to participate in climate change prevention. And that is what is the reality today, and that is one of the positive aspects that even the UN Climate Action is suggesting, it is promoting. So that is important. Another thing that is important here is in the context of nationalist politics. I have told you that the focus now is on nationalist politics. This we can see for that matter in US. US has withdrawn from the Paris Agreement just because of its own national interests. Recently, in the case of the Amazon fires, we saw that how the president of Brazil also went ahead to the extent to say that it is not being compensated for maintaining these forests. So it is clearly showing that nations are now interested in their personal gains rather than thinking globally, and that is the nationalist politics that is taking place, which is having an impact on the climate action. So that is important. Another thing that is important is the two-track approach which has been suggested here. Now, basically, the editorial is giving us a solution and just saying that a two-track approach is what needs to be followed. The first approach is the diplomatic approach. This is through negotiations between different countries. The Paris Agreement in itself was a type of a diplomatic approach in itself. It was trying to build a consensus between different countries. So that is one approach. The second approach is the changes we brought about in the economies themselves within the countries by ensuring that some action portfolios are what are laid down, and these portfolios are what are followed by different countries. For example, it suggests that what should take place is that the cities should be made climate friendly. That is the first suggestion. They should be made resilient to climate disruption. Solar energy is what has been talked about in the article, that there should be a shift towards solar energy. There should be a coalition of business and research. So these two approaches, which means that first approach is diplomatic approach at the international level, and at the national level, every country should have an agenda to work towards ensuring that the society is more and more climate friendly rather than contributing to climate change. So that is what is important. Another important analysis that the editorial is offering is in the context of India. That is what has been given here. Now basically, what is important for India is that if these global negotiations are failing, this is something that is not in the interest of the nation. Primarily because India is one country which is extremely vulnerable to climate change. So an international agreement on climate change is in India's interest, and this is what is the agenda, this is what is the ideology that India should manifest, rather than it should go in the favor of itself contributing to climate change. So that is what has been talked about. There is a need for enhanced global collective action, which India needs to focus upon. Also, there is an opportunity for India to become an example for others. As of now, India has an opportunity to make a change in its development model. We are a developing country, and that is why the industries that we are setting up, the infrastructure that we are setting up, we have an opportunity to set it up in a more climate friendly manner, to set it up in a manner which the West has not done. So that is what has been suggested. We should have a domestic energy policy which should be more sustainable. As of now, India is focusing more on fossil fuels, but a shift is what is very much required. India can become a global climate leader is what has been talked about. Also, in the context of India-China, it has been discussed that instead of competing with each other, at least on the matter of climate change, where the interest of both the countries is similar, India and China must cooperate. So that is important. Another thing that has been talked about is the idea of climate politics. This is also a key word. Now, definitely, climate politics is something that is difficult in an era of nationalism, but this is the reality of international geopolitics, where climate politics has come to stay, and you must use this also as a key word if you have an opportunity to focus. The entire global fraternity should be on energy, on efficient and sustainable urbanization. All of this is what the editorial is advocating. Needless to mention, the article is important. It is relevant for the environment section of the General Studies mains paper, especially this part of the paper, the article, which is talking about all the current events in the context of climate change. This is the most important aspect in the entire analysis. So that's about this particular article. Coming to the next article, Seeking to Secure. Not a very important article, just some basic point is that it is now being propagated, or the government is now thinking that GST numbers are what should be linked with Aadhaar. Now this is basically something that has been planned in the context of first issue, which is vis-a-vis frauds that are taking place. A lot of frauds are what have come to light. This data is what has been given in this article, that how much crores of money is what has come to light, that how much money is what has been lost, and how much has been tracked by the GST intelligence. So to prevent fraud in the context of GST, it is important that it be linked to Aadhaar, and this is what has only been admired in the editorial, that this is a step in the right direction. So that is one thing that you need to know. Another thing in this context, what you need to know is that GST has not resulted in the amounts of revenues as was expected, and that is why now linking it to Aadhaar is also crucial for the government, so that its losses can be minimized, and therefore the revenue losses which the government is facing are what can be reduced. So that is what has been discussed in this particular article. So that's about this particular article, and that's about our discussion. And these were the only two important articles that I have found. There is another article in this editorial in the context of the Jallianwala Bagh tragedy, but only if that article gives us data which we can replicate in our paper will that article be useful. Otherwise, that article, in my personal opinion, will not provide us material, is not giving us facts which can be stated in the UPSC mains paper. But nevertheless, it makes a good read, so you can give it a read. But for the UPSC, only these two articles were important. So that's about these two articles, and that's about our discussion today. I thank you all for watching the video.